This is Coding Maths Mini Number 8, Rounding. Shout out to my British viewers who love their maths. Today we're going to talk about rounding numbers, a subject that a lot of people take for granted, but you can do some pretty cool things with. Rounding is simply a function that takes an input number and gives back an output number that's either the same as or somewhere in the vicinity of the input. The most common type of rounding is to round to the nearest integer. If you have 7.4, for example, you're in between integers 7 and 8. You're closest to 7, so that's your answer. If you were at 7.8, you'd be closer to 8, and that would be your answer. Of course, 7.5 is dead center between the two, so the convention is usually that if the fraction is 0.5 or higher, round up. Otherwise, round down. Now that's all stuff that you should already know from grade school, but it's worth mentioning just to make sure we're all on the same page. Now most programming languages have some kind of math library that usually contains three standard rounding functions. I'll describe the JavaScript versions, but in most languages, you'll find nearly identical functions. Math.floor rounds down to the next lowest integer. So 7.0 will round to 7, as will 7.1, 7.5, and 7.999. If you want to see an example of math floor in action, check out mini number 5 on random numbers. This is usually the same thing as converting or casting a floating point number to an integer, which usually just chops off the fractional part of the number. Math seal, or ceiling, does the opposite, always rounding up to the next highest integer. 7.0 would still round to 7, but 7.anything will always round up to 8. 7.9, 7.4, 7.0001 all go to 8. Then there's the old standard math.round, which rounds to the closest integer using the 0.5 and higher rule. So 7.1 would round down to 7, and 7.8 would round up to 8. Now many programmers go along with these built-in functions and do just fine, but we're going to create a couple more rounding functions that are super powerful. The first one allows you to round not just to integers, but to any number of decimal places, or even to the nearest 10, 100, 1000, etc. Now of course, when you're dealing with long floating point numbers, you often need all those digits for accuracy and calculations. But there are plenty of times when you don't need them, particularly when you're displaying a value to a user. For example, if you're making a slider control that has min and max values of 0 and 1, you probably don't need to display the value of that slider to 10 decimal places. One or two decimals would probably be fine. Another obvious example is anything to do with money. Say you're doing a shopping cart app. A user buys something for £7.99 with a 5% VAT. Another shout out to the Brits here. The total would be 8.3895, but you can't charge that amount. You have to round it to the nearest cent, 8.39. Now, your built-in math functions don't help much because they only round to the nearest integer. So what you do is multiply by 100. This gives you 838.95. Then you round, which gives you 839. Then you divide by 100 to get 8.39. Now, say you want to display the value of pi, which is 3.14159265358973. But you only want to display it to three places. Multiply by 1000, which gives you 3141.59265358973, round to get 3142, and divide by 1000 to get 3.142. If you want it to one place, multiply by 10, round, then divide by 10, and you'll get 3.1. So we have 10 for one decimal place, 100 for two places, 1,000 for three places. Of course, 10,000 would give you four places, and so on. Now here's a trick. 10 to the power of 1 is 10. 10 to the power of 2 is 100. To the power of 3 is 1,000, and 10 to the power of 4 is 10,000, and so on. So this matches up perfectly to the number of places we want to round to. So we can create a round to places function. I'll add it right to the utils library. This takes the value that you want to round and the number of places you want to round it to. First, it calculates a mult variable. It uses mathpow to raise 10 to the specified power. So if places is 2, we're saying mathpow 10, 2, which is 10 to the power of 2, or 10 times 10, or 100. Then we multiply the value by that mult variable, round it, divide it by mult, and return the result. In this simple test file, I'm just going to log the value of pi to 1, 3, and 5 places. And you see this gives us 3.1, 3.142, and 3.14159. An interesting thing about this function is that you can feed it negative place values to round to powers of 10. For example, minus 1 will round the input value to the nearest 10, minus 2 to the nearest 100, and minus 3 to the nearest 1,000. And passing in 0 simply rounds to the nearest 1, which is the same as using math round directly. Here's an example of rounding a large number to tens, 100s, and 1,000s. And here's the result. So this function will let you round to any decimal or any power of 10, but sometimes you need to round to other values. A great example is a snap-to-grid function. Say you have a 40-pixel grid, and you want to snap objects so that they always align with this grid. Well, we can just lose all the mathpow stuff and switch the order of things around and create a round nearest function. So in the grid example, say the current value is 113, and we want to round that to the nearest multiple of 40 to align with the grid. We divide value 113 by 40, and we get 2.825. Rounded, that is 3. Multiply 3 by 40 to get 120. And that's the multiple of 40 that's closest to 113. Here's an example file. I set a grid size of 40 pixels. Then I listen for a mouse move to get the current mouse coordinates. I draw a grid using this draw grid function, which just draws a bunch of horizontal and vertical lines spaced using grid size. Then I use round nearest event client x grid size to get a rounded x value, and I do the same thing with client y to get a rounded y value. Finally, I just draw a circle at that xy position. We run that, and see that no matter where I move the mouse, it draws a circle centered on one of the grid coordinates. Try changing grid size, and you see the new grid drawn to that size, and the circle will still automatically snap to that new grid. So, a couple of new utility functions. I'm sure you'll find these very useful. See you next time.